Haloperidol is an antipsychotic agent used to treat schizophrenia and other psychoses, as well as symptoms of agitation, irritability, and delirium. In this video, let's find found. What is haloperidol? What class of drug is haloperidol? What is haloperidol used to treat? Who cannot use haloperidol? What are the side effects of taking haloperidol? How does haloperidol make you feel? How to use haloperidol? What is haloperidol? What class of drug is haloperidol? Haloperidol, sold under the brand name Haldol among others, is a typical antipsychotic medication. Haloperidol is used in the treatment of schizophrenia, tics and Tourette syndrome, mania in bipolar disorder, delirium, agitation, acute psychosis, and hallucinations from alcohol withdrawal. Haloperidol was discovered in 1958 by Paul Janssen, prepared as part of a structure-activity relationship investigation into analogs of pethidine, meperidine. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is the most commonly used typical antipsychotic. In 2020, it was the 303rd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 1 million prescriptions. What is haloperidol used to treat? Haloperidol is indicated for a number of conditions, including for the treatment of schizophrenia, for the manifestations of psychotic disorders, for the control of tics and vocal utterances of Tourette's disorder in children and adults, for treatment of severe behavior problems in children of explosive hyperexcitability, which cannot be accounted for by immediate provocation. Haloperidol is also indicated in the short-term treatment of hyperactive children who show excessive motor activity with accompanying conduct disorders consisting of some or all of the following symptoms: impulsivity, difficulty sustaining attention, aggressivity, mood lability, and poor frustration tolerance. Haloperidol should be reserved for these two groups of children only after failure to respond to psychotherapy or medications other than antipsychotics. Who cannot use haloperidol? Haldol, haloperidol, is contraindicated in patients with severe toxic central nervous system depression or comatose states from any cause. Hypersensitivity to this drug, hypersensitivity reactions have included anaphylactic reaction and angioedema. What are the side effects of taking haloperidol? Common, greater than 1% incidence. Extrapyramidal side effects including akathisia, motor restlessness, dystonia, continuous spasms and muscle contractions, muscle rigidity, Parkinsonism, characteristic symptoms such as rigidity, hypotension, anticholinergic side effects such as. These adverse effects are less common than with lower potency typical antipsychotics, such as chlorpromazine and thioridazine. Blurred vision, constipation, dry mouth, somnolence, which is not a particularly prominent side effect. As is supported by the results of the aforementioned meta-analysis. Pharmacodynamics. Use of the first-generation antipsychotics, including haloperidol, is considered highly effective for the management of the positive symptoms of schizophrenia, including hallucinations, hearing voices, aggression/hostility, disorganized speech, and psychomotor agitation. This class is limited by the development of movement disorders such as drug-induced Parkinsonism, akathisia, dystonia, and tardive dyskinesia, and other side effects including sedation, weight gain, and prolactin changes. Compared to the lower potency first-generation antipsychotics such as chlorpromazine, xanthixol, flufenazine, and methotrimeprazine, haloperidol typically demonstrates the least amount of side effects within class, but demonstrates a stronger disposition for causing extrapyramidal symptoms, EPS. Low-potency medications have a lower affinity for dopamine receptors, so that a higher dose required to effectively treat symptoms of schizophrenia. In addition, they block many receptors other than the primary target, dopamine receptors, such as cholinergic or histaminergic receptors, resulting in a higher incidence of side effects such as sedation, weight gain, and hypotension. How does haloperidol work? While the exact mechanism is not entirely understood, haloperidol is known to inhibit the effects of dopamine and increase its turnover. Traditional antipsychotics, such as haloperidol, bind more tightly than dopamine itself to the dopamine D2 receptor. With dissociation constants that are lower than that for dopamine 0.4, it is believed that haloperidol competitively blocks postsynaptic dopamine, D2, receptors in the brain, eliminating dopamine neurotransmission and leading to the relief of delusions and hallucinations that are commonly associated with psychosis. It acts primarily on the D2 receptors and has some effect on 5-HT2 and alpha-1 receptors, with negligible effects on dopamine D1 receptors. The drug also exerts some blockade of alpha-adrenergic receptors of the autonomic system. Antagonistic activity regulated through dopamine D2 receptors in the receptive trigger zone, CTZ, of the brain renders its antiemetic activity. Of the three D2-like receptors, only the D2 receptor is blocked by antipsychotic drugs in direct relation to their clinical antipsychotic abilities. Half-life. Following oral administration, the half-life was found to be 14.5 to 36.7 hours. Following intramuscular injection, mean half-life was found to be 20.7 hours. How to use haloperidol? Schizophrenia, psychosis. Moderate disease, 0.5 to 2 mg, Q8-12 HR, initially. Severe disease, 3 to 5 mg, Q8-12 HR, initially, not to exceed 30 mg. IM lactate, prompt acting. 2 to 5 mg Q4-8 HR, PRN, may require Q1 HR in acute agitation, not to exceed 20 mg per day. IM decanoate, depot. Initial, IM dose 10 to 20 times daily, POS administered monthly, not to exceed 100 mg. If conversion requires initial dose greater than 100 mg, administer in two injections, for example, 100 mg initially, then remainder in 3 to 7 days. Maintenance, monthly dose 10 to 15 times daily PO dose. 4. Off-label. May be needed for ICU delirium, use only haloperidol lactate for 4 administration, do not use haloperidol decanoate. 2 to 10 mg initially, depending on degree of agitation, if response inadequate, may repeat bolus Q15-30 minute, potentially doubling initial bolus dose. When calm achieved, administer 25% of last bolus dose Q6-HR, taper dose after patient is controlled. Monitor ECG and QT interval. QT prolongation may occur with cumulative doses greater than or equal to 35 mg. SODSTA points reported with single doses greater than or equal to 20 mg. Tourette disorder. 0.5 to 2 mg PO Q8-12 HR initially, if severe symptoms necessitate increased dosage, titrate upward to 3 to 5 mg POQ8-12HR. If patient remains inadequately controlled, daily doses up to 100 mg have been used. Safety not determined. Are there specific concerns about haloperidol and pregnancy? US FDA pregnancy category C. Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans. But potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women, despite potential risks. That's all the information about haloperidol we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.